everybody, welcome. Thank you so much for coming. We're having a kickoff event this afternoon for the new degree option in farm and food systems here at Greenfield Community College. My name is Abrah Dresdale. I'm faculty and coordinator of the new degree, and I'm gonna give everybody a little bit of an overview of our first pilot year here at GCC. Greenfield Community College for the last year and a half has been exploring what kind of offerings it could give to the community in terms of food and farming and local food advocacy, which, as several of you know, is a burgeoning, exploding interest here in the Pioneer Valley and in the greater country and across the globe. So for the last academic year, we have had two or three pilot courses, and we're gonna show you all those today and then show you where we're headed. So farm and food systems at Greenfield Community College embodies a whole systems approach to sustainable farming and local food advocacy. Students here learn hands-on skills through agricultural courses, such as four-season farming, beekeeping, and organic gardening. We prepare our students to be critical food systems thinkers who understand how the global food system operates and the benefits of a resilient local food economy. Permaculture and regenerative design is another trademark of farm and food systems. Students read the landscape and create backyard, urban, and homestead designs that contribute to self-sufficiency while restoring ecosystem health. Through community-engaged service learning projects and internships that go beyond the walls of the classroom, students apply their skills and make real contributions to the world around them. So beginning this fall 2012, we will be offering an Associate of Arts in Liberal Arts with an option in farm and food systems for a total degree worth of 60 to 61 credits. So we have an interdisciplinary curriculum here, mentioning that it really takes on a whole systems approach. So we're not just zeroing in and looking at, well, how do you grow food organically? Or zooming in and looking at food policy in a really myopic lens. We're looking at how all of these pieces are integrated so that students who come here receive a really solid foundation in sustainable food farming, local food advocacy, and food systems thinking education. So we're drawing from courses in environmental studies, science, agriculture, and perhaps more. We will see how this first year unfolds. So I just want to give you all a little tour of this pilot year. We kicked off in fall 2011 with EVS 118, Introduction to Food Systems, a three-credit course in social sciences. Students were broken down into different research pods. So we had students looking at cultivation, looking at processing, distribution, waste, policy, etc. We took several field trips. Here we're at Bostrom Farm in Greenfield, which is a grass-fed beef and pork farming operation in the meadows. We took a trip to the Food Venture Center, the CDC's Food Venture Center, with John Waite, who's here in the audience, and talked about farm to school and cold and frozen storage challenges in the valley, looking at seconds that come in from the farms and how are they processed into value-added products like applesauce and apple butter. Here are the beautiful students now in their gorgeous sanitary hair caps, holding up frozen peppers. And we took a trip right next door to look at Catalyst Kombucha and spoke with Will Savitri about processing and distributing beverages and the challenges of that cold storage issue. And then we looked at distribution. We met with Devon Whitney Deal from CISA and went to the Greenfield Farmers Market, where students interviewed farmers about their practices and what were the benefits of direct sales and what were the challenges of getting into the market. And then students had final presentations that were preceded by a community stakeholder charrette in October, where they gathered goals and priorities of the community and then delivered their final presentation and findings in December. And this project will be a rolling project that continues on to food systems this fall. And here you have them, the 21 burgeoning food systems planners. Then moving on to the spring semester, currently, permaculture design, a four-credit science lab. And you may be asking yourself, well, what is permaculture? What is regenerative design? It's really a practice of observing patterns that are found in nature and then mimicking those beneficial relationships to the design of systems that meet human needs while simultaneously regenerating the land. So we went on a couple of field trips. Here we are at Laughing Dog Farm, looking at four-season farming with Daniel Botkin, sitting inside his hoop house while he's growing greens in the middle of winter. 2 days before we arrived, his goats had had kids, and we got to hold them and pet them, and they are just total medicine in the dead of winter. Made a stop to Uppingill Farm, looked at their A-share cows, and bought some raw milk, came home very happy. We went to Nasami Farm, one of those blazing hot March days, and had a base mapping course where students learned how to triangulate objects in the landscape and map them out to scale. And there we had a tour with Kate Pauling, who talked with us about seed storage and collection and seed propagation in their greenhouses. We took a field trip to the homestead of Keith Salzberg, who is a permaculture designer here in Greenfield at Regenerative Design Group. And the class was on regenerative hillside farming, how to stop erosion and passively infiltrate rainwater to harvest crops in a more sustainable manner and in harmony with the landscape. So we had an outside classroom. We talked about different strategies and how to measure slope, how to apply berms and swales on contour and brush dams. We went upstream to where there was a gully forming, and we captured the water high in the landscape by building these brush check dams with the students. Keith's talking here about farming on contour and working with the land to capture water instead of eroding down a central gully. And students get the hands-on skills of learning how to work with an A-frame and a water level to map out equal contour lines on the land. And then we had sort of an experimental class this semester, Permaculture Student Forum. Well, these six students have been working very hard all semester. They've been charged with the possibility of creating a community-engaged living laboratory outside the science wing here on the south side of the building. The prospective permaculture garden right outside our new zero net energy greenhouse. And so they have been doing site analysis and had a community stakeholder charrette and are about to give their final presentation. And we took some field trips to look at prototypes or case studies of how this is happening elsewhere at other institutional levels. So we went to UMass's permaculture garden outside their new dining commons. And we talked with Ryan Harb and other students there about how they made this dream into a reality, how they got to the White House and were acknowledged by President Obama for being leaders in sustainable campus movements. Here they are in this very space. We had 50 people come for a stakeholder charrette who contributed their ideas, their designs, what sort of a space they would want to see here. Because really, this garden is for GCC, but it's for more than just GCC. It's for the whole community. And this idea grew out of the food systems course. How could we identify a leverage point in the community that could really instigate change, that can demonstrate ways that food can be grown in traditional ways, and then also in non-traditional ways, and really cultivate marginal spaces that are often overlooked and produce way more food in a capacity that we didn't think possible. So here they are engaging the community. 50 people showed up, and from that, we had a fabulous article written in the Greenfield Recorder right outside the new site as this picture being taken. We've got the three students, myself, and on the left is Tony Reiber, who's our new greenhouse technician, and he'll be teaching soil science this fall and working with me to help steward the permaculture garden along with physical plant and science instructors and student interns, or at least that is the proposal on the table so far. And then we took another field trip to Wellesley College in Eastern Massachusetts, and they have hired Dave Jackie and Keith Salzberg, two renowned permaculture designers, to create what they call an EAT garden, an edible ecosystem training garden, where they are doing science research about phenology and do nitrogen fixers actually improve soil, and actually cataloging all of this as part of their science curriculum. So here we are with Dave Jackie, sheet mulching, or doing soil regeneration, laying down layers of cardboard that create habitat for worms and other beneficial soil organisms. Samantha is here pulling out crown vetch. There's an unwieldy amount on the site, and we were doing a bunch of site repair this spring to get it ready for some more planting. We We have Crystal here, one of our students, and then students from UMass and Smith College all congregated, shared their ideas about their permaculture projects, and dug into some mulch and soil. And then lastly, the students have been meeting with these designers. So here we are, Regenerative Design Group in downtown Greenfield with Keith Salzberg, talking about their designs. Are they feasible? How much would it take to install? How can we capture rainwater and prevent erosion in our parking lot and water our crops at the same time? So on your seats there should be little green sheets, and those are invitations to the students' final permaculture design presentations coming up next week on Tuesday from 1 to 4 p.m., and you are all invited. And then I want to share with you about farm and food systems internships. We've had a couple this year and more coming this summer. So here I have a student, Jenny Christian, who's working with the Franklin County Tech School on integrating permaculture and farming into their tech programs. And they've got their greenhouse, which normally the horticulture program uses, which is excellent to propagate annuals. But here on the left side, they're propagating edible starts. It's in some incredible infrastructure that she has really taken and transformed and growing food that they're then integrating into their culinary program and their restaurant at school. And there's another student right now who is woofing, who is doing organic gardening and farming in France and Italy. And she's been blogging and keeping notes of recipes and lessons learned. And then we had this opportunity, it was fabulous. NOFA New York granted scholarships for students to come to their winter conference in Saratoga Springs. So we got up bright and early at 6 a.m., rented the GCC van and drove over to Saratoga Springs to learn about winter storage crops and seed saving and jobs in the local food economy. And so I want to just share with you all that we are officially enrolling for farm and food systems. It is a real thing. We have passed the degree option. The pilot year has been very successful. Our reskilling series classes, permaculture and intro to food systems, all over enrolled. And so we feel very excited to be offering this. So if you're curious, wondering, is this degree for me? What can I do with it? What are my next steps or options after GCC? Or even if you're interested in taking a reskilling class, because how they're designed is they're for credit and they're also blended, which means we can offer them as community education classes for folks who aren't seeking credit but really want to gain these skills for maybe a personal hobby, a homestead, or thinking more about entering the local food economy as an entrepreneur. So if you're interested, please visit us at our website, gcc.mass.edu/farm and food systems.